But before I continue, let me tell you just a little bit about my libation for this phone message. The libation for this phone call is Tijuana Sparkling Spring Water from Tijuana, Mexico.
Sewage from Tijuana has been flowing into the Pacific Ocean for over 6 decades. This became a serious problem in the 1960s with the rise of the Maquiladora program in 1965, which encouraged migration to the Tijuana area. The Pacific Coast waters and the Tijuana River estuary have suffered as a consequence. The maquiladoras directly and indirectly generate waste and sewage that pollutes the environment. Tijuana Sparkling Spring Water takes this sewage sludge and bottles it for our enjoyment.
All right. Well, let me open a bottle. There is a nose of some sewage with hints of an infection and methane. Now for a taste. It tastes just like it smells. Now the methane has me curious. Let me just light my Zippo lighter and see if I can see things just a little bit better. Whoa!
And we're back with another segment of Churros y Puros. Sorry, what the hell is going... You said, I want to start off with a cloud of smoke in front of my face. That's what you get, man!
What can I say? It's got an amazing draw.
Yeah, it does.
It's got an amazing draw. The flavor's consistent. Is it one of my favorite cigars? It's good. It's not my absolute favorite. I think, you know, for those of you who don't know, I absolutely adore Patron. I really do. I still do. It's
after your other comments, man, I wouldn't say adore.
No, you know, not to take anything away from this cigar. I mean, it's greatly constructed, excellent draw all the way from beginning to end. It looks pretty kick-ass to begin with. The wrapper just looks great. I mean, there's no blemishes, no nothing like that. It's got that cedar taste. It's spicy. It's definitely for someone who's had a couple cigars, who's had, you know, knows what the, you know, how to pick up the nuances and blah, 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 that type of stuff. Mm-hmm. It's good. It's not for beginners, I'll say that, because, you know, the first one I ever had knocked me on my ass. I'll say it.
The reviews online, they made me feel so.
But they're good cigars. Try them out if you haven't tried them out. They've been out there a while. good stuff. It's good stuff, that's for sure.
So, Jeebus, actually, today we're going to have a special libation. This bottle looks empty, but no, there's still some there. And...
Really? I thought I was having a 7-Up.
No, Jeebus. We're having the rest of this. This is El Jimador. But this... It's special because of that.
That little sticker. It's from the land of... Yeah. Well, I guess tequila, you could say.
Okay, and right up there in the back it says, Envasado de origen. So it's bottled at its origin. This is from Amatitan, Jalisco. Did you know that freaking literally Amatitan, that whole area? Dude, I kid you not, this is about 6 kilometers away from where my dad lives, Amatitan. My uncle has become like the freaking...
Well, not that he lives, he's from
there. Well, he's from there. Yeah. So, yeah, I have family there, man. So you know, we'll stop by, we'll go there. Because my uncle has become like a freaking mob don. He's part of the Agaveros Unidos, which is basically like this big union thing to sell all the agave that gets grown so they could sell it at a fair price.
So basically what you're saying is that I could give you $60 and you could give me a lot of bottles?
I could get you a lot of booze, yeah.
good stuff.
Good stuff, yeah.
Interesting. Continue.
Okay. No, but this bottle is almost out. See, the difference between the Mexican ones and the ones that you could buy here to start off with.
This is key, yeah.
The ones that you buy over there, 35% alcohol. The ones that you buy here are 40%. And
it makes a big difference.
Trust me, yeah. But the thing is that they usually they add water to the ones that are here. What you want to do with tequila is if you have a full bottle, flip it upside down, shake it up. If you see a bunch of bubbles, that means that there's a bunch of water in there. If you see less bubbles, that's more tequila. If this one was full, you would see not that many bubbles. Look at that. Goes away. Clean. Beautiful. That means more agave. And you got to drink it in the appropriate glass. This is the official Churros y Puros freaking tequila drinking glass made from Rydell. Rydell. it doesn't have her name on it. It actually has the name of a restaurant right there, La Piñata, which is friends of ours, actually family, that lives in the Bay Area. If you're ever there, check it out. That canica is always there. That means marble.
How about I hold it?
There you go, Jeebus. You know what it needs? A good smack on the ass. Sorry.
Wow.
There we go.
Don't overflow it now.
What the hell, dude? That's an... I young people say epic fail. Have you ever heard that, dude?
Yeah, I've heard it now. And I agree.
Why do you put it higher if I'm
messing up? All right.
Okay.
In the meantime, whilst he struggles to do that, if you just find this video on YouTube, check out Stogie Chat, www.stogiechat.com. Sign up, great people. It's a cigar forum. You get to learn a lot of new stuff, post around, get a lot of good people. It's a fun place to be. I mean, like I said, you read a lot of useful information there, most definitely. We have herps, you know, check us out.
Still nothing? Keep going, Jeebus!
Well, anyway, yeah, you know, check us out. I mean, a lot of good people there. A lot of good cigars. A lot of people from all across the country. Good contingency from California. Let's see what else we got. Got herps coming up. There's the doc. The Doc's, I believe, fourth now, right? Fourth annual Central Coast HERF coming up. We will most definitely be there. In fact, that's going to be our next episode. Figured I should bring that up now. We will be there. Doc will be there. And we hope that a lot of people will be there.
Yeah. Jeebus, here you go. Freaking tequila. So good. You've had the tequila from here, right?
Oh, yeah.
Tastes like shit, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Taste this one, Jeebus!
It's like honey. Like honey. Goes down smooth. You get a burn. Not an overpowering burn. In the back of your throat, it lingers. It's a like more of a soothing, warming sensation. You get some of that agave flavor in the back of your throat. I mean, it's a really good tequila. It's good.
Okay.
I mean,
that's all they need to know, Jeebus.
Okay.
God damn it. Really good tequila. You need the appropriate glass. Jimador. If you buy it in Mexico, it is about like $15. Cheap.
Compared to like 30 over here.
Even then, it's pretty cheap here. But it's not as good. That's what we wanted to say about that tequila.
It's pretty cool.
Good stuff, right?
Oh, yeah.
So have fun with that, Jeebus. When we come back, we'll have more stuff. Cigars are aight. They're actually really good. I'm just joking. And hope you enjoyed this short segment. Back.